guys, my name is Lainey and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be making a very simple and family friendly chili. Now today I am going to be using minced beef, but you can simply make this vegetarian by using minced corn. So let's get on with it. The ingredients you are going to need are, as I said, the main ingredient I am using is extra lean minced beef. Now I get this from Muscle Food and it is only 4.2 grams of fat per 100, so it is super lean. I'm always trying to get extra vegetables into my husband, as you might do with your kids, so I am adding in some chopped bell peppers. I'm also going to add in some chopped red onion. I prefer the taste of red onion to regular onion, but any onion is fine. I've got 3 finely chopped cloves of garlic. Now, the amount of spice you add in is completely up to you. I've got a half a chili pepper finely chopped up here because my husband doesn't really like things too spicy, and I'm gonna make this more of a smoky flavor. But if you like to add in spice, go ahead and add in as much chili as you want. If you like it a bit milder, add in less. I'm using black beans today because that's what I had in my pantry, and that's how flexible a lot of my recipes are. You can just substitute in what you have available to you in your pantry. So normally I would use kidney beans, but the black beans will act just the same and taste just as good. I'm going to be adding in some of these Italian chopped tomatoes. I simply picked these up in Sainsbury's. For the other spices, I'm going to be adding in some ground cinnamon, some smoked paprika because I really love the flavor of smoked paprika, some cumin, and some ground coriander. I'll also be adding in some salt and pepper seasoning to taste. If you want to substitute in or out any of these, feel free to amend them to your own liking. I'm going to be serving up my chili today with some basmati rice. I have to confess, I am not the best at boiling rice, but Muscle Food have it covered. They have this microwavable basmati rice, which is so easy. You just pop it in the microwave and it's ready to be served with your chili. This is super fast and anyone can do it. And it's a great one to have in the freezer. You can just portion it out in the freezer and save it for later for those emergency meals. So simply starting this recipe, I am going to use this garlic fry light spray. I'm going to be using a medium-sized saucepan, and then we're going to put it up to a medium heat. As the saucepan heats up, we add in a few sprays of our fry light spray. Chili simmering on the pot for as long as possible. I sometimes make this in the morning and put it in the oven on a very low heat and just leave it simmering for the entire day. But it's already the evening time and we want to eat this tonight. So I'm going to leave it for the next probably about 30 to 45 minutes. But again, I say the longer you leave it, the better it tastes. It absorbs all the spices and they come out. So this one is a great one for the next day. So the chili has been on the stove for about 45 minutes now and it is starting to smell amazing. So here we have it, all ready to be served up. I'm simply going to serve it on a bed of rice. And then instead of using the traditional sour cream, we're gonna make it a little bit healthier, and we're gonna use this natural quark that I get from Asda. Quark is like a high protein soft cheese, very similar in consistency and in taste to sour cream. It is the perfect accompaniment to your chili. I'm also going to top my chili with some delicious cheesy goodness, because I like to make everything a little bit extra. So we're gonna add on some of this Eat Lean protein cheese. I picked this up from Muscle Food. Hope you enjoyed the recipe. This is a very simple recipe that all your family can enjoy. Make sure to hit the subscribe button if you are new to my channel. And of course, if you enjoy this video or any of the rest of my videos, make sure to give them a thumbs up. See you in the next healthy recipe.